Now tell us what some of those names, those exclusive names that you give to your products.
Okay.
I've seen some of them, but I can't recollect now.
Okay, we have three.
But because you Nigerianized them. Yeah.
We have three major brand names that we use as our own brand name.
Yeah.
But we can put anything on each bar to represent the personalization.
Okay.
So we have Desire, Indulge, and Sensation.
Okay.
They actually represent the types of chocolate.
Choc Boy, Desire.
God bless you.
Choc Boy, Indulge.
Choc Boy, Sensation. So those three names, one is for the milk, the Sensation is for the milk, Indulge is for the white, Desire is for the dark. And those names were specifically chosen to interpret a lot of things about the chocolate product, the product itself. Desire is a dark chocolate, it's the healthiest form of chocolate, but it is the least interesting in taste. Hence the name Choc Boy Sensation. Those are the backdoor names.
Yeah.
But we can have Akomi, Akomu. We can have any name.
Akomu Desire.
Akomu Desire.
Because I've seen some of these on your Instagram page.
Yeah, and any name anybody wants to have on it and brand it with it. So we receive
suggestions. I can imagine a Nigerian
pushing
his trolley at Heathrow Airport, for instance. And then you want to buy, at the toll-free. And you want to buy chocolate and you see
your name, Femi.
And you see Akomu.
Akomu.
Ah, Edro.
Chocolate me, my
true. You know, silly, you know. And I thought that was a very, very commendable, it was a gloriously applaudable concept, you know, when I saw it on the wrappings. And the way you wrote it like a signature.
Yes.
As if somebody was signing somebody's name
exactly.
on it. And these are traditional indigenous names.
Exactly.
And then there are some street lingos.
Yes.
Street slangs.
Slangs that we use also.
That you also used on some of them.
Yes. And that's because two reasons. It will shock you how much creativity we have here in Nigeria. I know you're working with a team of creative people. From my graphic team to my content team, they are highly creative and innovative people. And they keep thinking of methods that we can use to make this thing very unique. So for example, the product itself, the wrapping, the brand, the basic wrapping, that the basic design that each wrapping has, it's actually, if you look in detail, you will see it's African in nature.
Yeah.
Then you now go a bit to, okay, the first attraction to the person, the names, the street slangs that we can have on them. And the next thing, so we use the names, street slangs and everything that people can easily identify with. And we put them there and people, okay, oh, nice, I want this. Nice, I want this because this is mine, this is it, I like this and stuff like that.
It reinforces your sense of identity.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So it just gives me this little edge that makes people want to pick it up from the shelf before they think of.
You recognize, maybe consciously or unconsciously, but you seem to have recognized that buying is an emotional decision.
Unconsciously.
Rather than a rational decision.
Yeah.